Welcome to the Incompetent Griller, where I'm going to teach you, an incompetent griller, how to look like you know what you're doing when grilling in front of your family and friends. Today we'll be smoking a whole turkey on a Weber kettle grill. You'll want to get your coals started in a chimney. Sharp-eyed viewers will notice that I have some old coals in the background from my last time grilling. Since most are still good, I'm leaving them in so I can hopefully get a longer cook time in the end. I'll explain why later, but just know that this is not necessary for you. My chimney takes about 20 minutes to get coals ready, so once everything's hot, I'll show you what our setup's going to be. Keep in mind that we'll be cooking hot and fast instead of low and slow, because we're not going to give our turkey any chance to dry out. This is going to result in a juicy, delicious bird that will make your in-laws finally happy to claim you as part of their family. To keep the grill hot, be sure to open your vents all the way, both on the top and the bottom. We'll be doing indirect cooking, so all the coals are going to be to the far side. Place a tray underneath where the turkey will be and fill it about halfway with water. That will help us create a humid environment for the bird to bathe in. Once you have everything in place, go ahead and put the lid on so that we can start creating that sauna-like environment. The lid vents will need to be opposite of the coals, so that the smoke has to come up and over the turkey before it can escape. Being the incompetent griller that you are, you probably lack a fancy thermometer probe setup, but that's okay. We're going to take that cheap, instant read thermometer that you wisely bought before cooking your own turkey and hold it through the vent to get a general idea of the ambient temperature. Right now, we're at around 460, 470 Fahrenheit, so we're ready to start smoking. The secret to this amazing turkey is that the night before, you're going to inject it with Tony Sachery's injectables. There are a few different flavors available in the store. I'm going with their garlic and herb injectable, but you can use whichever one sounds good to you. Just make sure to massage the bird after injecting it to get that flavor throughout the meat. After all, this bird gave its life for you. The least you can do is give it one final massage. You're then going to coat the outside of the bird with Tony's Creole seasoning powder. As I failed to record these preparatory steps of the process, if you need any help, follow the link in the description to Kate Stewart's tutorial on how to use Tony Sachery's injectables. I also added two mesquite wood chunks on top of the coals to add some more smoky flavor. Feel free to use whatever wood sounds good to you. This recipe works best with a 10 to 12 pound bird. However, the turkey in this video was 18 pounds, which is why I added the extra coals in the beginning. But that's because my wife was thinking about her oven and not the size of my grill. However, we're still able to get the lid on, so this should work. Leave the lid on for 45 minutes, because as the Bible clearly teaches, if thou art looking, thou art not cooking. During this 45-minute wait, you can keep yourself preoccupied by playing a few rounds of the greatest game on earth, Crokinole. If you need to buy a board, there's a link in the description that you can use to save yourself some money when you purchase a board of your own. Now that 45 minutes have passed, you'll be basting your turkey with a mixture of melted butter and more Tony's seasoning powder. We've rotated the bird 180 degrees to make sure that we've got even cooking all the way around.
On the turkey.
Where on the turkey?
All over.
Okay. You're then going to pause the video that you're recording and try again because you just learned that you never taught your kids how to baste a turkey properly. Now that you've taught your kids to be more generous with their basting, just keep going until the bird has been buttered up properly. Then pop the lid back on for another 45 minutes, which means you can either play more Crokinole or, since your children beat you during the last break, you can do some scouting of the professionals over at Crokinole Center or Board Game Sports Network. I'll leave links to about 45 minutes worth of videos in the description. After each side of the turkey has had one turn at being closer to the heat, go ahead and take a temperature reading, even though this can be kind of awkward to do while holding the camera in one hand. Right now, we're at about 151 in the breast. Since we need to get up to at least 165, go ahead and rotate the bird one more time, baste it again, and then put the lid back on for another 45 minutes. At this point, I was kind of curious about the ambient temperature inside the grill. It seems we're down to 325, so we definitely have lost some heat from where we started, but this should be more than enough to get us to our end goal of avoiding Salmonella. So there's no need to worry about adding any more coals at this time. Now that another 45 minutes have passed, go ahead and rotate the turkey one more time. Let's check the temperature on what previously was the far side. We're at almost 160. On the side that had been closest to the heat, we're at 172, so we're definitely finished there. We'll just do a quick check of the thighs. This one's done, as is this one. So we're going to baste this one more time, then put the lid on for a little longer, just to make sure we get that last side up to temp. I don't see a need to go to the full 45 minutes, so probably just about 20 minutes this time. Once it's done, I'll bring it inside and show you the finished product. Look at that bird. That is looking good. And check out this slice. It is crazy juicy and looks fantastic. So I'm going to stop the video now and start eating. Let me know of your own successes down in the comments after trying this method yourselves. Have a great day.